गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, द डबल इंजन सरकार इज ऑन एन ओवरड्राइव टू पुट उत्तर प्रदेश ऑन द रनवे टू ग्रोथ एंड ग्लोरी आफ्टर ओपनिंग इंडियाज लॉन्गेस्ट एक्सप्रेसवे दैट इज द पूर्वांचल एक्सप्रेसवे फॉर द पब्लिक टुडे द फाउंडेशन स्टोन वॉज लेड फॉर जेवर इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट. The new international airport, which will be the fourth largest in the world, is slated to be completed in the next 36 months. This will be India's gateway to an exclusive club of which only a few have managed to earn their place. Once completed, Uttar Pradesh will be the only state with 5 international airports. A dream that was conceived in 2001 by the BJP government is taking place today. And Prime Minister Modi didn't mince words to target his rivals for bad planning which kept Vikas or development projects in oblivion.
पहले राजनीतिक लाभ के लिए आनन फानन में रेवड़ियों की तरह इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट की घोषणाएं होती थी, कागजों पर लकीरें खींच दी जाती थी, लेकिन प्रोजेक्ट जमीन पर कैसे उतरेंगे, अड़चनों को दूर कैसे करेंगे, धन का प्रबंध कहां से करेंगे, इस पर विचार ही नहीं होता था. इस कारण से प्रोजेक्ट दशकों तक तैयार नहीं होते थे, घोषणा हो जाती थी. प्रोजेक्ट की लागत कई गुना बढ़ जाती थी, फिर बहानेबाजी शुरू होती थी, देरी का ठिकरा दूसरों पर फोड़ने की कसरत होती थी. लेकिन हमने ऐसा नहीं किया.
But the BJP claims that the Yogi and Modi Vikas push is backed by statistics. Here are 5 signature projects that are top of the list. The 341-kilometer Purvanchal Expressway is open for the public. The foundation stone for the Jewar Airport has been laid. Over 67% of the Bundelkhand Expressway is already complete and the rest is slated to be completed by April 2022. 93% land has already been acquired for the construction of the Ganga Expressway, while 75% of the work on the Gorakhpur Link Expressway has been completed. The opposition, while it will never admit all of this, listen in to Yogi Adityanath on how he took on his detractors.
गन्ने की मिठास को कुछ लोगों ने कड़वाहट में बदल करके यहां पर दंगों की एक जो श्रृंखला खड़ी की थी, आज ये देश के अंदर एक नया द्वंद्व बना है कि यह देश गन्ने की मिठास को एक नई उड़ान देगा या जिन्ना के अनुयायियों से फिर दंगा करवाने की शरारत करवाएगा. और यही तय करने के लिए आज आप सबका आह्वान करने के लिए मैं स्वयं आपके बीच यहां पर उपस्थित हुआ हूं.
Well, the opposition is busy downplaying this feat. SP Supremo Akhilesh Yadav branded the growth story as a jumla, while Congress leader Aziz Qureshi, following Akhilesh Yadav's Jinnah playbook, asked for a king-size poster of the man behind the partition of India to be put up at Aligarh Muslim University. Listen in to Akhilesh Yadav and then Aziz Qureshi.
जितने भी एयरपोर्ट बने हैं सब घाटे में हैं. दिल्ली का एयरपोर्ट कई हजार करोड़ में घाटे में है. तो सोचो, एयरपोर्ट घाटे में, हवाई जहाज चल रहा है वो घाटे में, तो ये भारतीय जनता पार्टी का गणित क्या है जो मुनाफा लोग कमा रहे हैं. ये एयरपोर्ट इसलिए बन रहे हैं कि जिस समय एयरपोर्ट बन करके तैयार हो जाएगा भारतीय जनता पार्टी इसको भी बेच देगी. ये शिलान्यास हो रहा है इसलिए खाली एयरपोर्ट इनको बेचना है.
जिन्हें कोई गाड़ी है, कोई 1906 से लेके 1926 तक जिना आवाज दी फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट कैंडिडेट थे इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस के मंत्री, जैसे नेहरू से ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट थे वो, कि फोटो उठा दो अलीगढ़ में, उठा दो फोटो उठा अलीगढ़ में, क्यों उठा दो, मैं कहता हूँ बड़ा करके लगाना चाहिए फोटो उनको, मैं कहा उठता ना है भी और लाट करके लगाता फोटो में बैठे यदि वो करवानी है यदि खिदमात जो थी आपके मट्टी डाल देगा उसको.
Well, and that brings me to the legitimate question on the news hour tonight. Is Jinnah Prem Saleem Jewar? That's the question and the debate. Jewar versus Jinnah. That's the hashtag and the debate coming up on the other side.
You're watching the news hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Joining me tonight on the debate is Sanju Verma, national spokesperson of the BJP, Mohandas Pai, chairman, Aryan Capital, Shantanu Gupta, author, Ghanshyam Tiwari, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Tehsin Poonawala, political analyst, and Kamruzzaman Chaudhary, leader of the Congress Party, joining me live from Kolkata. But my first question goes to Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari. Ghanshyam Tiwari, do you think Mr. Akhilesh Yadav made a mistake by getting into Jinnah? Because that really has set the tone. Congress bhi Jinnah Jinnah kar rahi hai, Samajwadi Party bhi Jinnah Jinnah, and the BJP is talking about Gen Next development. Do you think development is going to be the agenda in these elections, or is it going to be Jinnah?
Well, let me start with Jewar, because that's also part of the debate. Economic Times reports February 2020.
The proposal for airport in Jewar was first mooted by Rajnath Singh in 2001. So if Prime Minister Modi is blaming Rajnath Singh, he can. It was backed by Mayawati ji, who acquired 2000 acres land, and Samajwadi Party wanted to build the airport in Agra. So if the Prime Minister inaugurates an airport that, or does shilanyas of an airport that has been in the making for 20 years, it is still not made, and goes on to do an election rally, one must ask, look at the airports in Uttar Pradesh. Now, the Uttar Pradesh airports, who is running Varanasi airport? Who is running Lucknow airport? The point is, zameen kisan ki, vision kisi party ka, paisa taxpayer ka, banane wale Switzerland ke, bhashan aur rally BJP ki, aur jab ban jaye, to aisa na ho, theka adani ka, munafa adani ka, sauda beimani ka. So, if BJP has decided that one nation, one corporate, ya hum do, hamare do will run the nation, and the Prime Minister goes on to inaugurate hospitals and medical colleges that are not complete, expressways which were set up by Akhilesh Yadavji's government, airport that is not made, no one can fly in the next 3 years, and Rajnath Singh ji, who mooted the proposal, was addressing some booth rally in Sitapur. This is the story of Bharatiya Janata Party. In the last entire year, it was Abki Bar Yogi Sarkar in 2021-2022. But when that completely flopped, they are saying that if you want Modi in 2024, you have to elect BJP in 2022. That BJP is now dependent on Modi, and Modi is dependent on taxpayer money to do rallies on incomplete projects, demonstrates the reality of development of Bharatiya Janata Party.
Well, Sanju Verma, respond to Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, because today he's playing a T20 and he's hit sixer after sixer. And the job of fielding the ball, which has been, hit out of the stadium, is yours. Over to you, Sanju Verma.
Thank you, Navika. You know, I just want to say one thing. Hindi mein kahawat hai, khisiyani billi khamba noche. Hum sabko pata hai. और एक मशहूर कहावत है, बेगानी शादी में अब्दुल्ला दीवाना. लेट इट बी वेरी क्लियर, इफ यू लुक एट द 2017 असेंबली इलेक्शन, समाजवादी पार्टी वॉज राउटेड 47 सीट. 2019 अगेन एन एब्सोल्यूटली डिसमल परफॉर्मेंस. सो द पॉइंट इज दैट समाजवादी पार्टी हैज स्टिल नॉट बीन एबल टू गेट ओवर इट्स फेटिश for this Yadav versus non-Yadav narrative. The BSP has not been able to get over its fetish of forward versus backward classes narrative. Congress is nowhere in the equation, so I won't even bother to dignify what the Congress means for Uttar Pradesh election. The point is, as Prime Minister Modi said, baki jo vipaksh ki partiyan hain, unka nara hai atkana, latkana, bhatkana. सबको अंधकार में रखना, सबको अभाव में रखना. यू डेलिबरेटली वॉन्टेड द पीपल ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश to be bereft of the fruits of development. Otherwise, tell me, Navika, between 2002 and 2017, in 15 long years, only 467 kilometers of expressways were built by BSP and SP put together. In just the last 4.5 years of the Yogi government dispensation, we built more than 641 kilometers of expressways, and another 600 kilometers are coming to fruition. Ab baat karte hain Jinna ki. Bar bar Jinna ko kaun sammanit karta hai? Taliban ko kaun sammanit karta hai? The likes of Om Prakash Rajbhar, who thinks Mukhtar Ansari is holier than thou. Mukhtar Ansari ke bhai bolte hain, mujhe to Samajwadi Party ticket dene ke liye tayyar hai. When you are pandering to the lowest common denominator of the likes of Om Prakash Rajbhar and Mukhtar Ansari and co, then you do not have any political credibility or moral high ground, Ghanshyam Tiwari, to come and lecture the BJP. Twitter par share banna, TV channel par aakar bhashan dena, aur ek baat hoti hai, zameen par utar kar chunav jeetna, aap bhool chuke ho. The double engine sarkar will better its score than even last time, because we've outperformed and you've underperformed even as an opposition. You failed to do the basic job
संजू वर्मा जी, आप 47 सीट्स की बात कर रही हैं, 2019 की बात कर रही हैं समाजवादी पार्टी के लिए. अच्छी बात है, अपना अपना पास्ट याद रखना चाहिए और कई बार आंकड़ों के लिए सही भी होता है. बट लेट मी टेल यू दैट हिंदी में एक ये भी कहावत है कि जो बीत गई सो बात गई, और आज नया सवेरा है. और इस इलेक्शन में शायद समाजवादी पार्टी का उतना ही हक है लड़ने का जितना आपका है. तो आने वाले समय में पता चलेगा किसका पलड़ा भारी है. बट लेट मी आस्क कमरुद्दीन चौधरी, ये व्हाट इज रॉन्ग विद द कांग्रेस पार्टी? यू नो, ममता बैनर्जी एंड द तृणमूल कांग्रेस हैव स्वेप्ट द कार्पेट फ्रॉम अंडर योर फीट इन मेघालय. Mamata Banerjee comes here, picks up anybody she wants from the Congress party. Everybody in the Congress party, whether it is Ashok Tanwar in Haryana or Aditi Singh in Uttar Pradesh and Amethi, all of them are leaving and going away to other political parties. And some places, 12 of them go and your government, you know, is in dire straits in that place. And your leaders are talking about Jinnah and 1947 and 1906. Are you in a time warp, Mr. Chaudhary?
Navika, you must be doing better research than me.
Obviously.
You must understand
that goes without saying. Even Mamata Banerjee and her party, BJP and its party, everybody is doing better research than the Congress party.
I hope you will let me speak my time out here. The point that is here, whether Mamata Banerjee is taking away the discards of the Congress party or what she is, her future will be, that we have all seen during the prior to the Bengal elections, when hordes of Trinamool MLS were joining the BJP. So we do not want those type of leaders who jo dal badlu din mein hai fir raat mein jaakar ghar wapsi karte. We don't want this type of leaders any longer within the party. Second point, the point that Mamata Banerjee is trying to put out across India is cutting on the secular votes or the votes of the Congress party, which means indirectly helping the Bharatiya Janata Party. Let the results come out of the 2022 election, or for that matter, just 2 days, wait for 2 days for the Tripura municipal elections. Ye doodh ka doodh aur pani ka pani ho jayega, result aane dijiye, aapko kon kaha pe khada hai, ye debate we can do it.
To aap keh rahe hain ki BJP jeet jayegi Tripura mein bhi. Aapka kehna hai ki BJP Tripura mein jeet jayegi aur ab aapki dushmani BJP se nahi hai, Mamata Banerjee se hai, yehi keh rahe hain aap.
I never said this. Our fight is again Godse ke samarthakon se. और गोडसे के समर्थकों से हमेशा रहेगा. इसमें कांग्रेस पार्टी कभी कम्प्रोमाइज नहीं करेगी. देश के जनता को यह बोलना चाहता हूं कि ममता बनर्जी ये गोडसे के सपोर्टर्स के साथ में सरकार बनाकर बैठी थी. कांग्रेस पार्टी आज तक कभी भी इनसे समर्थन नहीं लिया एंड विल नेवर. will never join hands with these people who have destroyed the secular fabric of the country. Now, coming to the
your
main point of debate that you have organized today about the Jewar Airport.
चौधरी साहब, इतना ज्ञान आप दे रहे हैं मुझे, महाराष्ट्र में बता दीजिए, वो शिवसेना आपके साथ है, वो किसका सपोर्टर है, वो किसके साथ रहते थे पहले, थोड़ा सा मुझे समझा दीजिए, मुझे मेरा रिसर्च देखिए बेटर है, लेकिन यहाँ पर मेरा रिसर्च फेल हो रहा है।
वांट टू गो इनटू दैट टाइप ऑफ डिबेट, ना, नाविका जी, कांग्रेस पार्टी हैज ऑलवेज मेंटेन्ड इट्स सेंट्रिस्ट अप्रोच, वी हैव अलाइड विद द एक्सट्रीम लेफ्ट ऑफ द CPIML इन बिहार, एंड वी हैव अलाइड विद द एक्सट्रीम राइट ऑफ द शिवसेना। नाउ यू सी हाउ द वंडरफुली द महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट इज रनिंग, वी डोंट हैव ए बुलडोजर गवर्नमेंट लाइक इन उत्तर प्रदेश, इन महाराष्ट्र, वेयर पीपल्स रिस्पेक्टेड, where Mr. people's Bhinder, views, where their wishes are respected, where people are casting.
Maharashtra government is not running, it is looting.
मैडम आप अपना सरकार का भलाई के बारे में सोचो, आंदोलनकारी जो 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 फार्मर्स आंदोलन में बैठे हुए वहाँ पे, वो आज इस कदर आप उनको भोकला चुकी है उनको, तो आज आपको जो है कि ये सोच रहा है कि मेवर एयरपोर्ट, अरे कम से कम एक बार तो एक्नोलेज कर दिया होता कि बिकॉज ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक स्ट्रॉन्ग इकोनॉमिक फाउंडेशन द कांग्रेस पार्टी इज लेट in today India, you are spending on a mega airport in Uttar Pradesh, and we as Indians are proud of that airport. But so one thing, can you please tell me what is the total budget of the airport? Is it 30,000 crores as the PM said, or is it 60,000 crores as the my office of the Yogi Adityanath has put out? There is a discrepancy out there. Second, 250 years ago, we got in a East India Company into the country, which looted us, plundered us. Now you are giving such a big airport for 40 years lease to a foreign company.
Madam,
आप किस तरफ अपना देश को बेचने जा रहे हो? कितना चीजों को बेचोगे मैडम? Can you just get to reply to that? You don't have any answer because your only
one minute. Mr. Mohandas Pai, you just saw how easy it is to distract the Congress party. You know, this debate really was about UP. And Mr. Chaudhary is very happy talking about Tripura, Maharashtra, and he tells me ke my research is not very good. Mohandas Pai, I want to ask you, Mohandas Pai, why is Jinnah so important? Is there less of a destruction of the Congress party that today they have to even talk about Jinnah in this light, saying that he is number two to Mahatma Gandhi, coming from a Congress leader, of the seniority of Mr. Aziz Qureshi? And have they left the pitch for a BJP versus Samajwadi party battle because they're so busy destroying themselves?
You know, Navika, I'm very astonished how the Congress party is out of date with the reality of India and the aspiration of the young people of India, who are the real voters of this country. Jinnah is immaterial to the great, great majority of the people of this country. The young people want jobs, they want development, they want growth, they want economic opportunities. They're not bothered about Jinnah. And Jinnah is a bad name to the great majority of people because all of them blame Jinnah for the partition of this country. They've forgotten him. To resurrect an old ghost who's passed away and make it an election issue shows how out of date people are. I do hope the Congress party will focus on development, will bring forward the agenda for development, try to get jobs for young people and remake itself to meet the aspiration of the young people of this country. They're so out of date, it's ridiculous. Every time you hear a Congress leader speak, it hurts all of us who, you know, were born in an era where the Congress party was dominant. Now the Congress party is not dominant. We don't want the Congress party to disappear. It has become a relic of the past. It is out of date with reality. India requires a strong opposition. They must get their act together because we need an opposition party in this country. Now look at the opposition. Mamata Banerjee is taking the place of the Congress. She wants to be the big leader in the opposition. We have the SP fighting. SP is also out of date with the reality of UP. UP has developed tremendously in the last 5 years. You asked Shantanu to give you the data. I wish all these people who talk about Jumla, Gimla, Bimla and all the kind of stuff, look at the data of Yogi has done. No chief minister has done as much for UP as Yogi has done, Yogi Adityanath has done in the last 5 years, is unbelievable. I just today had an NRI from Singapore who is from Lucknow. Sir, he said, law and order in UP is tremendous. Women can walk at 1 o'clock in the night in Lucknow and they feel safe.
It is among before. The lowest states of the GSDP about living right outside. Now.
And I feel sorry for these people who are out of date, who are out of reality, and who are just putting on old bogies as if, you know, the secularism issue is dead. We are a country where we have a constitution. Everybody has the right to religion. Secularism is never in danger in this country because the great majority of people, 110 crore Hindus, are secular by nature because they are polymorphic and they believe that every person has a right to his own faith. That is the Sanatana Dharma for 5,000 years. It's not because something written in the constitution that India is secular. And for these people to say, oh, they're secular, nobody understands what they say. They're out of date. And it's very, very sad to see the relics of the past come and talk about Jinnah. And, you know, try to resurrect old wounds. They'll never grow up. I wish they grow up. We need the Congress to be a good, effective opposition. And it's a very, very sad thing that people like this gentleman here still talk about some issues that are no longer relevant for the voter of today.
Well, Tehsin Poonawalla, I want to ask you, Ghanshyam Tiwari here or Akhilesh Yadav at least is raising some issues about airports, privatization, cost of living, things like that after he's gotten over the Jinnah phase. But what's wrong with the Congress party? Are you unable to find what is the real chord of the people, touch that chord and talk about issues this election, and then suddenly you'll come up, you know, Jinnah ki baat aap karein aur uske baad aap thode dinon mein kehne lag jayenge, oh, secularism has been forsaken by the BJP and they are only talking about issues that polarize the state and the people of the state. Well, who's talking about Jinnah? What is the relevance of Jinnah in an election of 2022?
Good evening, Navika. Thank you for having me on the show. Good evening to all the fellow panelists and your viewers. I'm going to be extremely brief and short. Amongst the various other talents that Sri Narendra Modi had, from having a digital camera before it was invented and sending emails to L.K. Advani before emails were made public, Mr. Narendra Modi was also the producer and director of Mungeri Lal Ki Haseen Sapne. Just like Ghanshyam Tiwari said,
Why do you start off with defamatory statements? Are you insane, Tehsin Poonawalla? The topic of the debate is UP politics. The topic of the debate is Jaywar.
All right.
You
all
are
right.
Doing a great take disservice to the Congress.
Tehsin Poonawalla, what's the point? What's the point beyond the intro that you've just given? What's the point you are making?
If I was interrupted, I barely spoke for 10 seconds. Amongst the various talents that Mr. Narendra Modi had, including digital camera before it was invented. And
we heard that part. What's the point? We heard that part.
Are you insane? Can't you come better prepared for debate rather than making
Sanju
a mockery of yourself?
Sanju ji, please Congress allow me to moderate the debate. Sanju ji, Sanju ji, मैं तहसीन पूनावाला को संभाल लूंगी. मुझे अभी मदद की जरूरत नहीं है. मैं I'll cry for help when I need it. But they say,
thank you, ma'am.
What's the point?
I'll come to the point.
Yeah.
Mr. Narendra Modi ji, our Honorable Prime Minister, is the producer and director of Mungeri Lal Ki Haseen Sapne. Like Ghanshyam Tiwari rightly said, the man inaugurated an airport that is not yet constructed, and in an advertisement on the front page, puts up factories of America and flyovers of Kolkata because there's done no development work in Uttar Pradesh.
Now,
and now there is nothing that the...
Can I... Debate.
This is unreal. Come on, man.
Sanju ji, I will give you time to counter. Please allow him to make his point and then I'll just end it now.
I'll just end my point now because continuously, you know, empty vessels make the most noise. So that's been proved on this show. But I'll just end my point about what Mr. Mohan Pai said, for whom I have a lot of respect, about the Congress. It is the Congress and it is Sri Rahul Gandhi who was the first to say demonetization will be a disaster for Indian economy. He was the first to talk about GST. He was the first to talk about COVID. And he said COVID. And I was on Times Now on 20th February 2020 when everyone was watching him and he said COVID will be a disaster in India.
since you have nothing to say about the development of Uttar Pradesh, since you have nothing to say about the Jewar Airport, you know, I thought you would come to the point, but if you're going to talk about demo that happened in 2016 and you're going to talk about other things of the past, then I'll send you the debate topic. Thoda padh lijiye, thoda tip lijiye, phir aungi aapke paas. Shantanu Gupta, Shantanu Gupta, what is the Samajwadi Party's problem?
You didn't allow Chaudhary to talk. I'm not talking. It's just so unfair.
If you talk on the Jewar Airport or Uttar Pradesh elections, be my guest. But you're going into history. You know, Aziz Qureshi talks about 1906. You're talking about 2016. Boliye.
Specific point. That the Congress out of touch.
Carry ad hominem attacks
look,
against the Prime Minister.
Because Mr. Pai
needs a specific... The only specificity is that he comes on Times Now.
Okay. That's great. It's still a greater identity than yours.
Sanju ji, you can't interrupt everybody. You can't interrupt. You are representing the party that is in power at the center and in the state, which is being debated. You will have to allow other people to speak for you to counter them.
It's immature behavior. It's actually immature behavior.
Tehsin, do you have objectives only or do you have a point you want to make?
End my point. I just want to make 2 points quickly. Mr. Gandhi has been in the forefront warning this country of impending disasters, whether it's economic or health disasters, and he's been proved right. Mr. Gandhi has a specific plan on crypto, something that and on blockchain technology, something Mr. Modi doesn't understand. Now to Uttar Pradesh. Let me tell your viewers and end out here. The Congress has a definite manifesto for Uttar Pradesh that's being made. The roadmap that the Congress will give to Uttar Pradesh will take Uttar Pradesh on the path to development. And the only people who have been able to develop
I do hope, like the jailer in Sholay, you know, you have some people standing behind you because aadhe left ko chale gaye hain congressmen, aadhe right ko chale gaye hain, aapke piche koi hai nahi. Aur in the last 7-8 years, I think you've lost 47 out of 52 elections that have been held in various parts of the country. Do hope for your sake and for this country's sake that you do get your act together and find some followers who will be behind you rather than other camps. But Shantanu Gupta, I want to come back to the point that Ghanshyam Tiwari raised. The question that Akhilesh Yadav asked, and he said, then why are you building airports if you have to privatize them? Respond to that question raised by Mr. Akhilesh Yadav.
I think I want to extend what Mohandas Paiji said, that how these ideas which I'm hearing in a debate are totally outdated. That Jewar Airport debate, which will be Asia's biggest airport, can be taken to Tripura and also to Nathuram Godse. I think that's the idea they're living in. Let me also remind the history because I'm being an author. So Ghanshyam ji is right. Rajnath Singh ji in 2001-2002 conceptualized first time the idea. It was called Taj International Airport and Aviation Hub. Okay, he lost his government. Mayawati became the chief minister and rightly so, all credit to her, she also pursued the topic with the UPA, then UPA government. UPA never wanted the project to happen for some reason. You can ask Tehsin why. Maybe they don't have the money they have in Commonwealth, so they didn't find it lucrative. They didn't find it lucrative enough. And then came Akhilesh Yadav. Akhilesh Yadav wanted to move it to Agra. And the reason was because that's near to Itawa. For all his life, he moved everything to Itawa. Itawa was the whole Uttar Pradesh for him. That didn't happen. And finally in 2017, and that's why I think I find the resonance with this double engine ki sarkar thing, that finally when Yogi Adityanath came, the project moved. And this is not about Bhumi Pujan, Ghanshyam. Let me tell you what happened before that. You have to get a DPR done. DPR will tell you a place, a feasibility study, and then you have to acquire land. Acquiring land from 10,000 farmers is not an easy job. I'm sure you know it. And then settling it. There are environment issues. There are NGT issues. All of them will be solved. Then the tender was floated. International tender was floated. Adani also applied. Adani did not get it. Adani also applied. Zurich AG finally got it. I lived in Zurich for a year. I lived very near to the airport. It's a wonderful, wonderful airport. And it seems this will be quite in lines of that. So finally, now Zurich AG got it. And what I'm sure, Ghanshyam, you have traveled across the world. You studied in a well-read university. all the airports in the world are run on the PPP, on the private model, right? Recently, GMR got the contract to run and manage the Indonesian airport, right? So GMR, GVK, Adani are running the project. Samajwadi Party, if wants to start a company, they can also start a company and run projects, right? I don't know which era are we living in. That's why I'm saying these ideas are very outdated. Ye private kar denge. They all, Airport Authority of India, GMR, GVK, Adani, they're sharing in it, right? I don't know which kind of model they're living in.
So Ghanshyam Tiwari, let me ask you.
The top line is, for me, the top line is that by 2024, 1.2 crore people can use this airport. 1 lakh people will be employed there. It will be biggest logistical hub. Real estate sector will be thriving. Hospitality sector will be thriving. I think that's the top line for me. Not God say, not Jinnah, not privatization. I don't know what are we talking. That's why I think I agree. I am hearing totally outdated ideas.
Ghanshyam Tiwari, respond to that. Is this country
January?
Going to talk about Godse and Jinnah, not about development and employment?
January 15, 2021. Adani Group won 6 airports, airport bids despite Finance Ministry Niti Aayog's objection, Indian Express. One nation, one corporate. Shantanu says that if Samajwadi Party wants to start a company, does that mean that BJP has started the company and that's called Adani? If one nation, one corporate or one nation, two corporates is a BJP formula, people, please, I was not interrupting you.
I'm asking a very simple question. Adani also bid for the project. Adani lost and
Please allow me to complete. The question is absolutely clear. The airports in Uttar Pradesh are currently being run by one group, and BJP is seen as the main driving force of the rising wealth of that group that has quadrupled and made the man richest man in Asia. That aside, BJP doubles its own income. That aside, the point that Mr. Mohandas Pai, I respect him, made, the point that Mr. Mohandas Pai made, maybe he's sitting too far away, because Akhilesh Yadavji has just retweeted the sad story that Uttar Pradesh mein Doroga Bharti ki pariksha dekar lot rahi ek yuvti ke saath gang rape, us peedi ke saath zeher khane ki khabar durbhagyapurna hai. Another story, barely 100 kilometers from Jewar Airport, is the story of Hathras. That har mahine 30 tarikh ko Hathras ki beti ka smriti divas manaya jayega. If Bharatiya Janata Party wants to stand on the foundation of Unnav, Hathras, what is happening every day in Uttar Pradesh, and say that Uttar Pradesh is a safe state, in a state where 45% of cabinet ministers have criminal charges, in a state where more than 100 sitting MLAs of BJP have criminal charges, then be my guest. But the reality is they are going to be routed because BJP does not believe ki inflation, mehengai, beruzgari, Uttar Pradesh mein propaganda is a problem. BJP's agenda, Uttar Pradesh's propaganda, the idea of Shamshan Kabristan, the idea that to deny employment to the youth and to project Adityanath for work that he has not done.
Well, okay, please respond, Sanju Verma.
Thank you. Navika ji, first and foremost, Ghanshyam Tiwari is well educated to know that airport construction maintenance is given on a long lease to private operators the world over. It is an internationally followed best practice. So the Jewar Airport, if it is in partnership with Zurich Airport, is no big deal. The second and more important point is this, that Akhilesh Yadav was rattled when the Purvanchal Expressway was inaugurated. He said, "Ye toh deri sochi. This was my idea." Do you know something, Navika? This lie has to be unfolded right now, right here in Times Now. Akhilesh Yadav prepared a detailed project report without providing for toilets on a 341-kilometer long highway, without providing for fuel stations. The Indian Road Congress, which is one of the regulatory authorities, put Akhilesh Yadav DPR, detailed project report, into the dustbin. Second point, it is an internationally and locally followed best practice that when you build big projects, unless 90% of the land is acquired, you cannot float a tender. Akhilesh Yadav floated a tender for Purvanchal Expressway after acquiring only 25% of the land. So Yogi Adityanath had to redo everything from scratch. Prime Minister Modi laid the foundation on 14th July 2018 of the Purvanchal Expressway, and it will be ready in the next couple of years. So where is the question of Akhilesh Yadav taking credit? Gomti scam, pension scam, laptop scam, parading Gayatri Prajapati with him till the Supreme Court said that Gayatri Prajapati, a serial rapist, needs to be arrested. What is the credibility of Akhilesh Yadav? UP के दो लड़के, आपका वो plan fair हो गया 2017 में, और अभी आप ये जो भाषण दे रहे हो on the lines of Jinnah, Taliban, समाजवादी पार्टी लीडर शफीकुर रहमान बर्क, who's your member of parliament from Sambhal, he compared Taliban to our freedom fighters. So what kind of political credibility do you have? Clearly,
this fight, this face-off in Uttar Pradesh is going to be very, very intense. The Samajwadi Party picking up issues, the BJP responding right back. It's even Stevens at the moment as far as firepower from Netas is concerned. But this is a winter where the heat is going to be rising, because this is the biggest state in India, and Uttar Pradesh elections can certainly never be a boring affair. If it is Jewar today, it was Purvanchal yesterday. We don't know what the next few days is going to bring. So keep watching this space as we keep bringing up the debates, the fights, and the face-offs coming up in Uttar Pradesh. Thanking all my panelists, but just before I take a short break, I want to tell you that on the other side of the break is Union Civil Aviation Minister, Mr. Jyotiraditya Sindhya, who's going to be joining me. And he's going to answer all those questions that the Samajwadi Party and Akhilesh Yadav have raised. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere just yet. We'll be right back.